Whoa, astaghfirullah, this is like a pedophile's dream.
Way of Life SQ, keeping it 100.
Just hold it right here.
Assalamualaikum, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm so grateful, thankful, humbled. Thank you. You're welcome for watching my video. Bye.
Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome for watching these videos, son. This Netflix movie, Cuties, is going to make you cringe. And it's for all the reasons that you don't want to cringe. It's a movie about a Muslim young girl who's being oppressed by the hijab, so on and so forth. But it takes a deeper and darker twist and spin. But before we jump into that, I have three major announcements that we're going to jump straight into the video. If you want, you can skip past this, no problem, but the real ones are going to watch this. The first major announcement is, as you can see, the merch is now officially printed and ready to go. If you haven't watched the Adidas video over here where they violated, put Israfil's name, the angel made a sneaker colorway with Israfil's name on it, the angel, that's just, wallahi, it's wrong. I wanted to make a play and a pun on Adidas, so I made the Akhirah shirt with the Adidas this text. I hope you guys like it. I don't know how I'm gonna sell it yet. I don't know, but it's only going to be shipped for free, free shipping across the United States. So if you're in the US, how do I do this? I don't know yet. I'm learning, your boy's learning along the way. But yeah, that's one thing that I want to announce. The second announcement is this. A lot of you have been asking me, SQ, how do I contact you? How do I contact you? Here's what I'm going to give you only exclusive access to because you didn't skip past this and you're watching this part right now, okay? If you would like to contact me for whatever issue that you have, okay, and you need to speak to me, whether you need advice right now or you need advice 7 months from now, I want you to DM me on Instagram right here, Way of Life SQ. All you got to say is SQ, I came from your YouTube channel. Once you do that, I'm going to flag your DM so that whenever you have a question, it immediately hits the top of my inbox and I can respond to you immediately. Okay, so I'm giving you VIP access, but it's only for those people who are subscribed to the YouTube channel and they actually came from YouTube. Just say, hey, SQ, I'm from the YouTube channel, and then I'll flag you, not a problem. And the third announcement, which is pretty dope, okay, I'm going to be on, all thanks to you, obviously thanks to Allah, obviously, but thanks to your, you know, asking and badgering, I'm going to be on Dawah Man's podcast on Monday, inshallah. So we're going to be filming this on Monday, inshallah. We're getting back on the details. I just WhatsApped him not too long ago. We're going to sort that out. So stay tuned for that. Dawah Man's podcast coming up on Monday. Stay tuned for that. Now let's jump straight into this video. Now, This movie, from Netflix is absolutely disgusting. And this is not just like Muslims saying this. Non-Muslims are saying this all over too. Because they're saying that this is promoting some hyper-sexualized sort of idea and shoving it down our throats. Here's what the movie's about. It's about a young girl, a Senegalese girl, right? In France, I believe, okay? And she's a hijabi girl. I wonder where they're gonna go with this one. Okay? There's a hijabi girl, and she's being shown that she's oppressed. Her family just wants her to follow this Islamic, barbaric, old school, oh my God, these camel riding people, come on. This ideology, this religion. But she doesn't want that. She wants to be liberated. She wants to feel free. And you know what's stopping her from being free? This freaking hijab. This scarf that's blocking her mind and her hair and her precipitation. Her sweat is being stopped by this hijab. She's getting hat hair, hijab hair from this. Come on now. Oh. They want to liberate her. And she sees how, you know how she sees the liberation? She sees other kids her age. 10-year-olds, 11-year-olds, twerking. And she's like, mama, mama, I want to twerk too, mama. Let this hijab go, mama. I want to twerk too. I want to throw it back too, mama. That's what she wants to do. That's what it is. Now it's a battle. Oh, my God. This is some epic stuff. This is some, like, you know what I mean? Oedipus level stuff, Shakespearean level stuff. There's a battle, the internal battle. Should I wear thy hijab? Or should I take it off and twerk on TikTok? What should I do? My family wants me to wear this hijab, this thing that's stopping me, but I want to liberate myself and twerk and throw it back and do all these dances and hyperly sexualize myself. What do I want to do? And of course, as you can tell, the twerking is gonna supersede. Her desire to twerk and desire to make TikTok videos and music videos is gonna supersede her desire to please Allah and uphold her Islamic tradition. It's interesting, isn't it? Now, that's not the crazy part of this, because that's a common story you've heard. We've heard it in movies like Hala, right? Where she's a hijabi, tries to get liberated. Isn't it crazy how the only time in like mainstream media they want to portray Muslims is Muslims who are weakened by their own faith? Why? It shows that, oh, we're equals. We're equals. We can vibe to each other. You have crisis of faith. I have crisis of faith. What? You don't go to church? Well, I don't go to mosque either. Wait, so you don't really pray? I don't pray either. High five. Let's be friends. That's what they want. The only way that we can relate to them is when we stoop down to their level. It's interesting, isn't it? That the only time they want to show a Muslim in the media is as a failure within their own religion. Wallahi. Wallahi. It's sad. It's sad. And it's that's not the worst part about this show. That's not the worst part about the show. This show is a pedophile's dream. This show, this movie from Netflix, is a pedophile's, a pedo's dream come true. It is nothing. And this is crazy that I have to blur out 10 and 11 year old little girls in my video. Like, how crazy is that? Why do I have to blur them out? Like, it's that, like, they're wearing like bras. Like booty shorts at 10, at 11, hyperly sexualized. And this is criticism not Muslims are giving, non-Muslims are giving too, by the way, okay? This movie is a pedophile's dream because it is just showing the youngest of girls, youngest of kids, throwing it back, twerking and all that good stuff, loving it, loving it. It's like this, the choreography of this video, of this movie was staged by R. Kelly himself. Like, that's how bad it is, guys, right? This whole thing is just a pedophile's dream. And everyone is complaining about this, not just Muslims. I'm complaining about it for other reasons. This is a sick movie. It's a sick movie trying to promote a false agenda in young girls' minds, right? They're trying to show all these kids, all these Muslim girls. Wallahi, you're out there, I know. You're addicted to Charli D'Amelio. Like, you, that's your idol? Charli D'Amelio? That's your idol? Dixie D'Amelio? That's your idol? For what? What have they achieved? Do you know who Sumayya was? Radiallahu an? Do you know who she was? Wallahi, you don't even know about your... That's the goal, people. That's the goal. To make you lose your own Islamic tradition. For you to look at these people as these gurus, as these idols, as these people that you want to look up to, but you forget your own people that you should be truly proud of. I can list you some people's names, some beautiful women names in Islam, and you wouldn't know them. Most of you won't know them. A lot of guys won't know them either. This is a design to help us forget our own tradition, and most importantly, forget the Akhirah, right? You see how I plugged in the merch, right? Okay, anyways, here's the point, guys. How long are we going to continue to give these networks, these corporations, our money? For how long, right? This is not the first time Netflix has done this. Netflix did that show about the Messiah, right here, about the Dajjal. That video is over there to watch. That was done by what? Netflix once again. And then Netflix does another video right over here with gay Jesus, astaghfirullah, right? And they keep taking our money. Now, I'm not saying they're taking your money. They're taking my money too. I'm subscribed to Netflix as well. So I'm not just saying you, astaghfirullah, SQ must be so great you don't have Netflix. Of course I have Netflix, right? But this is making me question what I consume as well. And that's why I'm working on a new TV show. If you guys have been watching my daily videos, I post daily, duh, right? I post every single day. And I'm headed, inshallah, not this Friday, but the following Friday, it got moved around. But I'm going to Las Vegas because we're filming a part of my show. Who are we going to have on that show? We're going to have brother Kevin Gates. My man, Kevin Gates is going to be on that show. How crazy is that? Right? Nate Robinson. We're going to have some more people too. But I'm filming a show, a TV show with a new Islamic network that is going to be, you know, Netflix worthy, meaning it's going to be binge worthy to that level, that quality. We're delivering that to you guys. But what's the point if you guys aren't even going to watch that? Don't you think we need to support each other? Don't you think that when that show comes out eventually, because we have to film it first, right? I've already started the filming, alhamdulillah. Don't you think that you guys got... That's the thing, guys. We got to support. And I made a video about this with the Yeezy video, right? that we gotta support Muslim-owned businesses. We gotta support Muslim entrepreneurs. We gotta support Muslim media. We got to support Muslim sort of ventures. The merch, support it. Not because like, SQ, like, yo, that design is corny. It might be corny. You might not even like it. But support it for the sake of Allah, because that same money is going back into these videos. I'm doing a MacBook giveaway, so I need the money. It's a long story. I'm going to get that too. And by the way, there was a fourth announcement that I couldn't remember. I'm making a video, a social experiment, where I'm going to be raising awareness about the Uyghur situation in China to like non-Muslims who don't know about it. I mean, even Muslims don't know about it. Let's be serious here. But I'm going to be raising it to them. The title of the video is going to be called Pronounce This Word or Pronounce This Name and Win AirPods, right? So basically, I'm going to go around to people and ask them to pronounce the word Uyghur. If they pronounce it correctly, they're going to win some AirPods. And in the process, I'm going to educate them about it, right? But I'm not going to put the title Uyghur in there. I'm letting you guys know this is an exclusive club. Only the exclusive members are going to know about these videos. All you guys out there who be leaving the comments, I love you all for the sake of Allah. Wallahi, I love you for the sake of Allah. You know I respond to every single comment, right? But I'm going to be making a video like that. I'm not going to put the title Uyghur in there because YouTube is not going to promote the video. Straight up, they're not going to promote it. So it's going to be called Pronounce This Word, Win $100, or Pronounce This Word, Win a PlayStation or something. I don't know. It's going to be something like that, some crazy prize. Okay, anyways, we got to support Muslim entrepreneurs, Muslim ventures, so on and so forth. Make sure that your Muslim dollar is going to support people who are actually doing their thing and doing something positive and something good with the money. You know what I mean? Like, make sure the money is going in the right direction. And we got a question if we keep supporting Netflix. They keep violating us, guys. They keep violating us. Nike's violating us. Adidas is violating us. Netflix is violating. Like, come on. We need to start our own Muslim media companies, which we are doing. Stay tuned, guys. A lot of great things are coming in. Drop your thoughts in the feedback in the comment section below. I love you all for the sake of Allah. If you're new to this channel and you would want to subscribe, between you and me, I don't think it's worth it. Watch some of my other videos right here. One's best for you, or one's my most recent video. And until next time, I'm out.